It's a tragedy not getting spare parts for a broken oil pressure gauge of your classic car. We are showing an enthusiast solution preserving the original appearance. It's really giving you a headache. An electrical display instrument broken in your beautiful and well-maintained classic car. How can you repair it without losing the original appearance? Old displays for fuel, oil, temperature, etc. are based on electromechanical instruments. Unfortunately, the original instruments are becoming increasingly difficult to find, especially those that are moving counterclockwise, like this one. So, how can you fix that problem? We were explaining analog display instruments based on Arduino for different applications. You're more than welcome to watch the videos. Recently, Dennis asked me whether this principle could be used as a replacement drive for classic car instruments. As a car lover, I immediately started designing a concept. A solution preserving the appearance of the original instruments while bringing technical improvements over the old technology. Some modern comfort, such as warning LED and buzzer, shall be optional. In case you are looking for parts, it might be worth contacting Dennis. The link is under the video. The project was a bit challenging, because we are aiming to replace all electromechanical instruments, such as voltmeters, ammeters, fuel, oil pressure and temperature gauges. In addition, it needs to be open for adapting to different car models. For all gauges, the same stepper motor type and the same microprocessor is applied while implementing the different functionality via software. The Arduino controlled stepper is fed from the 12-volt system via a 5-volt regulator. A network of resistors, diodes and ceramic capacitors is filtering out interference and it protects the processor from overvoltage. The new pointer drive is connected to the original connection terminals, where we can foresee a 5-volt supply for an external sensor module, in case we need it. The stepper motor's currents are limited by serial resistors, and 4 flyback diodes are protecting the processor outputs from voltage peaks occurring at the stepper coils. Further outputs are controlling 2 LEDs and a buzzer. The power supply is comprising a protective diode, an RC filter, a 5-volt regulator and an electrolytic capacitor which avoids oscillations. An external sensor module needs to be considered in the dimensioning. Selected by a jumper, we are using 3 analog inputs of the Arduino Nano board. 3 series resistors together with the ceramic capacitors are blocking interference. Overvoltage and incorrect polarization protection is realized using 6 diodes. Finally, we will be developing a printed circuit for our project. We made very good experience with PCBWay. Be it for hobby, school or your professional work, you're getting PCBs, CNC machined or 3D printed parts in excellent quality. Take the easy way with PCBWay. How are we actually implementing all these different functions in the software? Simply put, we want to get from the voltage measured on a sensor to the stepper-driven display. Depending on the sensor's characteristics, we are getting a linear or a nonlinear voltage curve over the measured range of the temperature, oil pressure, etc. From that voltage, we are computing temperature, oil pressure, etc., applying an approximation function. If needed, we can transfer these values to a computer for testing. Next, we are transforming the values to a certain scale. Let's see how this works in practice. We are measuring the sensor characteristics in case we don't have its data sheet available. In our example, we got 350 ohms at 100 degrees Fahrenheit, 270 ohms at 140 degrees, etc. In that case, a simple linear function is a good approximation to work within the code. The transformation to a nonlinear scale I'm demonstrating on an original temperature dial. 100 degrees Fahrenheit corresponds to 0% deflection, 210 degrees corresponds to 50%, and 250 degrees water temperature corresponds to 100%. Here, an exponential function is suitable for transforming our measured values to the original scale. The method works for any sensor and dial characteristic. That's promising, isn't it? A stepper motor is simply performing steps forward or backward. It's not giving any position information. To create an analog display, we need a zero point from which we are defining the deflection as a number of steps. If zero is the start of our scale, then maximum deflection is at the end of the scale. We are finding point zero by driving the stepper against an internal stop and then moving back a certain number of steps. In this way, we can vary the zero point. Overshoot clipping prevents the pointer from hammering against the casing, losing steps. For the low range under zero, there is a corresponding undershoot clipping. Our stepper pointer, LEDs and the buzzer are the motorist's interface. The code is loaded via USB, defining the type of instrument and all adaptation parameters, including the desired rotation direction. The voltages measured are processed digitally. Floating averaging prevents our pointer from constantly fluctuating through fuel sloshing in the tank, for example. Next come the transformation as well as filtering. After clipping, the actual stepper control is getting active. When switching on, a startup procedure drives the stepper to the internal blocking, then to the maximum deflection, and then to zero before measured values are displayed. Finally, we are having subprograms for serial communication as well as for LED and buzzer control. We are developing the solution out of love for classic cars. I'm hoping you could take away know-how from the methods explained. In coming videos, we are showing tests, evaluations and assembly. Now stay tuned and don't forget to support the channel. See you soon in the coming episodes.